Hey, smart homers! Welcome back to the DIY Smart Home Guys channel! Bye!
That's precisely why you don't let your kids play around with your video equipment. Today we have another video dedicated to the Hubitat Elevation Smart Home Hub, and we are going to cover how to get the Schlage Connect Smart Deadbolt models BE468 and BE469 Z-Wave locks connected into your Hubitat. Stay tuned. Alright, let's get into it. If you are a Hubitat user or you're thinking about becoming a Hubitat user, this video is for you. And whether you already own a Schlage BE468 or BE469 lock, or you're thinking about buying one, this video will cover several important aspects related to pairing the locks to the Hubitat, as well as general tips for using the Hubitat Lock Code Manager. I don't plan to do a review of the Schlage lock in this video, but let's cover a few details about the locks themselves. This lock series is Z-Wave enabled and it integrates into your Hubitat very nicely. It's a deadbolt only lock that can be opened with a mechanical key, exterior keypad, or remotely through your smart home hub. The pin codes for this lock can be anywhere from 4 to 8 numbers, and you can have up to 30 codes in a single lock. And you can set the codes from the keypad or from your Hubitat Lock Code Manager. The device takes 4 AA batteries, which will last you about a year. I'm using the Duracell copper top batteries, and that's what I get, but your mileage may vary. I'm also not going to cover the actual physical installation of this lock since it's pretty straightforward.
This video is not a paid endorsement, and I receive no compensation for making this video. All product links in the description below are affiliate links, and I may receive commissions if you purchase products from these links. Some products shown in the video were provided to me for free from the manufacturer. However, the video should not be considered an endorsement for any of these products.
The first thing that you're going to need is this lock's programming code. This generally comes on the paperwork that came with the lock, but if you're like moi, you have probably lost it. But never fear. If you remove the interior lock housing, you will find that code on a sticker on the back of the main circuit board panel. I've left a link to a few helpful videos in the description below. Once you have the programming code, you'll also want to take note of the default user codes. These will come in handy when we go to reset the lock. And now that you've got the lock installed, and yes, there is a video below, you will want to reset your user codes. If you already have codes from a previous installation, you'll want to make sure you've noted them down just in case you plan to reuse them. To reset all codes on the lock, we're simply going to remove the power from the lock by pulling the connector from the batteries. Make sure that the bolt is retracted in the unlocked position. Then we're going to discharge any residual voltage by pressing the Schlage button several times. Nothing noticeable is going to happen, but it is working. Then, while holding the Schlage button on the lock, reconnect the batteries. The green check mark should flash 3 times. You can then replace the battery cover. Now that that's done, we're going to press the Schlage button and one of those default user codes that we took note of earlier. This will cause the lock to go through a setup routine, and that's it. The codes are now reset. Now if you had this paired to a hub previously, this may not reset that connection to that old hub. At least it didn't on mine. Every time I locked or unlocked the deadbolt, I kept getting a notification from my Wink Hub, "Your door is unlocked. Your door is locked." And as always, before you try to pair this to a hub, you're going to want to make sure you do a proper Z-Wave exclusion. I've left a link to a video for exclusion tips and tricks in the description below. If you have trouble, check out that video. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for, here are the instructions for excluding the Schlage Connect Smart Deadbolt. First, make sure that that deadbolt is extended into the locked position. Put the Hubitat, or the hub you're using for exclusion, into the exclusion mode. You'll have 30 seconds for these next steps. Press the Schlage button, enter the 6-digit programming code we got earlier, and then press 0. If you see a green check mark, you're excluded. If you see a red X, you're not excluded. You can also verify this on the hub through the exclusion message. Now, on the inclusion side, it's a good idea to have a Z-Wave range extender near your hub and possibly near your lock. I'm using the AOTech Range Extender 6. You can try to move forward without it, but if, well, when you're experiencing these problems that we're about to walk through, these are best solved with the AOTech Range Extender 6. Examples of problems that I had are things like the lock not coming out of initializing mode, the not being able to properly set user codes, and the Hubitat not being updated when the Schlage is manually locked or unlocked. So if you do decide to go this range extender route, here is your plan. I would purchase 2 of the AOTech Range Extender 6s. I would place one within 6 feet or less of your hub and one as close to the Schlage lock as possible. Again, I try to get it 3 to 6 feet if I could. And here's a couple of very useful tips on the pairing. Number 1, Once the AOTech devices are discovered by the Hubitat, they come in as generic devices. You'll want to change the device handler to generic Z-Wave range extender. Number two, you'll want to run the repair Z-Wave network function inside Hubitat. And three, wait 24 hours after the repair function is complete before doing any work on your lock. Trust me, this is gonna keep you from going nuts. As a side commentary, there's a lot of conflicting information out there in the Hubitat forums on this issue. Many posts will tell you that you don't need a range extender if there's another Z-Wave device nearby, since the mesh network should take care of all that. Others are going to tell you that any wired Z-Wave Plus device will work as a range extender, so you don't need the AOTech device. Well, here's what I experienced. I tried new batteries in the lock. I had in-wall switches that are range extender compatible. I tried a whole host of other things. Once I put in the AOTech range extenders and followed the steps that I described, everything worked like a charm. Now that we've got that out of the way, the inclusion works identical. Inclusion works identical to the exclude. Make sure that the deadbolt is extended in the locked position. Place the hub into inclusion mode and get this done, this time within 60 seconds. Press the Schlage button, enter the 6-digit programming code. You should notice a yellow light flashing. Then press the 0 button. The orange light should start flashing rapidly. If you see a green check mark, this means your hub has been included into the Hubitat. If you see a red X, you're not included. You can also try to verify this on the inclusion message in the hub. And again, if you're trying to use a normal Z-Wave Plus switch or similar wired switch as your repeater, and you're still having problems thinking that this is going to be helping, that could be the problem in and of itself. Give that AOTech Range Extender 6 some more consideration. Okay, we're going to assume that at this point you have the lock included into your Hubitat, and we're going to walk through the next thing. So now we're back into the Hubitat software. First place I want you to go, let's run some tests on that lock itself. We're going to go over to the devices page. And let's take a look at that front door lock. And there's a whole bunch of things you can do here. So when it comes to, say, deleting or adding codes, you can actually do that from the device page. It's not quite as friendly as it is if you want to do it over there in the lock code manager, but you can do it from here. But the thing I wanted you to try first is note the state of that lock. In my case, I'm locked. We're just going to hit that unlock button real quick. And we should be able to see that it goes unlocked from there, and then we can click the lock again and it's going to roll back into the lock state. Now again, I have those AOTech range extender 6s in, so things are working pretty good for me. I was getting slowness and all sorts of things that I was describing earlier until I had those range extenders in, so highly recommend it. Alright, so you can lock and unlock. That means that everything's working, it's all pretty quick. Here also, you can set the code length, the lock pin code length. Make this as strong as your family can endure. At least 6, but go 8 if you can on that. Also, there's a little feature down here called lock code encryption. You're going to want to do that. That's going to encrypt the traffic with the events and everything that are happening within the Hubitat. So just in case and you got spying eyes. I don't know if that's a thing, but that's why it's there. And you're going to want to make sure that you're going to have the built-in app lock code manager. You're going to want to make sure that this is installed in your apps. And from here, things are pretty straightforward. If you add a new user, we can name this user video. We're going to say 1598 as the video pin code. The next thing you're going to want to do is click the locks that this is for. Now, this is important. Don't just go over here and click done. Please don't do that. Click your tab key or click out of it. You can say this is enabled here. Always disable on a specific date. You can enable it on a specific date, or you can start it and stop it between two dates, or you can disable it temporarily or permanently if you want to. For this, we're going to do always enabled. Click that done. Now come down and click that add this lock code button. Now once you do that, you're going to get this message here that says the code add request was completed. We'll click done from here as well. And you should see video always enabled, that's been added. So one thing also that I was experiencing before I had those AOTechs in here is it would go into the queue and it would rummage itself through the queue and it would then come back and say that it failed. So let's talk about that. So again, this was something that I experienced before I had those range extenders in there. I would send a code down through that lock code manager. It would tell me it was failed. When I went down and tried the pin code on the lock, it was working on the lock. So there was something going on between the report back. So the advice I have for you is if you set a pin code through the lock code manager, it tells you it failed, go down and check your lock. Yours might not be down. I don't know why I'm saying that. Go check your lock. And if the pin code works, you're going to need to delete it. And you're going to need to manually delete it. So if you need to manually delete a code from your lock, what you're going to want to do is put the deadbolt into the locked position, enter your programming code, then press the number 2 and enter the code that you're trying to delete. You should get the green check mark. If you get the red X, it means that that lock or that pin code was not in the lock. Now, if the pin code was added through the app and it did take it down on the lock side and you need to do a delete, then I don't want you to do that from the lock. I'm going to want you to use the app to do that. It's going to be much cleaner. So let's go check that out. So we'll go back into that lock code manager, our little video always enabled. Now here's one thing I like and I don't like. I'm conflicted. Whenever you bring one of these up, it is going to show you that lock code. So this 1598 is what we just put on there, always enabled. Just to delete, you're just going to want to click that, delete this and all user codes, and you're done. The other thing I don't like is there's no, hey, dummy, are you sure? It's kind of done now, isn't it? So there it is, it's gone, and nothing we could do if we didn't want to do it, except for re-add it. I know, it's easy, just say, you know, make a new user, and I just deleted the code, hopefully I remembered what it was. But anyway, that's how you do it, that's how you do a manual delete, and we roll on from there. So again, I can't reiterate enough that if you're going to take this on with the Hubitat, then I strongly recommend that you go out and get those AOTech Range Extender 6 models and put those one next to the lock and one next to your Hubitat, again within a few feet. And that's going to solve a majority of your problems. I can tell you that every headache that I had was solved by that, bar none. And that pretty much wraps it up. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to click like. Over here, there's a couple of other videos that I picked out just for you. You can follow me over on Facebook and Twitter. Both are at DIY Smart Home Guy. Until next time, cheers.
And today we have another video
dedicated